Welcome back. This is LearnFreediving.com. I am Master Instructor Rudi Castineyra, and today we want to start a series about technique. Yes, technique, or how to perform a particular skill. Now, for us in particular, the guiding principle, the guiding concept, every time we're looking at technique, whether we are looking at established technique that we think can be improved, or we are designing a technique from the ground up for a skill that we ourselves have invented, this principle is efficiency, the concept of efficiency. And if we design efficiency as, I guess, being able to achieve an optimal result with the least expenditure of resources, you can see how this is of particular importance for freediving, because in freediving, this is one sport where we need to be at our most efficient. Our resources, in this case, our energy, which is dictated by our oxygen availability, is always restricted. And as the dive goes on, those resources, that oxygen and energy, will only continue to decrease. And that is why I'm gonna call this series Efficient Techniques. Yeah, I like that. So let's go with that. Actually, no, not quite. The truth is that every freediver and every instructor tries to be as efficient as they can, but I doubt that anybody else out there spends the countless hundreds of hours that we do in hundreds of dives in trying to polish and perfect every single technique that we teach to our world champions, our instructors, and our students. Why do it in 6 steps if you can do it in 5? Can you do it in 4.5 instead of 5 steps? Can you do it in less time while actually exerting less energy? And so on and so forth.
We are truly obsessed with efficiency.
So rather, I'm gonna call the series
Ultra Efficient Techniques.
Yeah, I do like the sound of that. So, where should we start this Ultra Efficient Techniques series? Well, how about right at the beginning, at the start of the dive, the transition from the surface to the underwater world, the aptly named entry. This is one particular skill that without fail, I have seen the really, really vast majority of divers always perform wrong, including extremely experienced divers and a few world champions. I am not gonna name names, but the truth is that entering, transitioning from the surface to underwater is a technique whose mechanics and whose principles seem to elude most divers. So today, we're gonna teach you our techniques on how to perform your entry into the water in 5 simple steps. And rather than steps, I'm gonna call it a sequence of actions. Better, a sequence of 5 actions. And why do I call it a sequence? Well, it is because for this particular technique, it is extremely important that every one of the steps is actually related and comes concurrent with the one that came before. And so these are not steps that can be performed independent from one another. Each of them has to come exactly at a particular time after the previous step has been performed, but without giving pause in between them. That is the secret sauce for this particular skill. And so, is it really that important for us to learn how to do a proper entry? Well, yes, it is. And here's why. Let us understand that at the start of a dive, if we have done our breathe up or our breathing preparation properly, our lungs are gonna be full of air. And if you do a few of the more advanced breathing methods out there, such as the intrathoracic overpressurization, also known as packing, or if you use our proprietary 4-section breathing, you're also gonna have our airways full of air in your stomach as well. Plus, if we are knowledgeable about the way in which we should ballast ourselves, we're gonna try to use as little weight in our weight belts as possible. That's not a good combination for forcing a body to go from the surface to underwater. Therefore, every time we deal with this series of circumstances and we perform the skill in the wrong way, what happens is that we end up overexerting ourselves. We end up increasing exponentially our cardiac output, our pulse, okay? And we go underwater, fatigued, tired, stressed, okay? Not a good way to start a dive. Furthermore, with this thoracic cavity full of air, one thing that happens quite frequently is that if we do this entry the wrong way, where we tend, most divers tend to get both legs up and into their abdominal cavity so that they can then kick their legs up towards the surface, towards the air, what's gonna happen is that we're gonna create a drastic overcompression or overpressurization of all that air in the abdominal cavity. What's gonna happen next is that a lot of that air is gonna come and put pressure against our glutes. Now, every time that happens, we're gonna actually get a drastic increase in blood pressure, especially systolic values. And that is not good because every time we dive, especially deep divers, we already are gonna have an increase in blood pressure. So we don't wanna start our dive with an already high blood pressure. And by performing the entry the way I'm gonna show you right now, you will be able to tick all of those boxes. Now, to demonstrate the skill, I'm gonna call on our fellow master instructor and 8-time freediving world champion, Yasemin Dalkilic. We're gonna use one of her videos demonstrating the skill from, I believe it's 2002. And the reason why I chose to use this video over just, you know, using a much newer one is because the truth is that this technique in particular hasn't changed at all in the past 20 years. That is, if you know how to do it right. And so without further ado, I'm gonna roll the video of Yasemin performing her entry technique, and then we will proceed to review all of the steps. So here she goes. So now, let us roll the steps here, all of them, all 5 of them. Number 1, attain forward momentum. Number 2, upper body goes vertical underwater. Number 3, lead leg goes vertical in the air. Number 4, transition to the first restricted kick. And number 5, star full descent kicks. So now, let us watch Yasemin's video and stop every time she completes one of these motions. Notice how Yasemin is finishing up her breathe up on the surface. She is actually hanging on to an improvised small buoy she's using with a forward float. Notice at this particular point here, she starts to kick forward. So she does between 2 to 3 very short, very subtle, very relaxed kick cycles, and you can see that she moves forward. She now is ready to proceed to step number 2. Now, what happens in step number 2? As you will see here, Yasemin starts to bend her upper body down. But notice how Yasemin starts first with her hands, points her hands towards the bottom in a vertical position. Her hands are together. Her head is tucked between her arms. It's not her neck. It's not stretched backwards with her head looking at the bottom like many divers do, because if she kept her arms separated or her head tucked backwards like that, she would exponentially increase the cross section of her upper body, which would increase the drag against the water column. So she's being as streamlined as she can be. And the reason why she can afford to do it this way is because, and here's the big secret of this whole skill, she is converting the energy that she generated in step number 1, which she was pushing her body forward, kicking to gain forward momentum. Now, by moving her upper body downwards into a vertical alignment underwater, she is actually transferring that energy, that forward momentum, she is converting it into downward momentum. Now she's ready for step number 3, where the lead leg is gonna rise out up in the air and it's gonna come in vertical alignment with the rest of her body. And then again, notice how only one leg did the trick. She doesn't need to do both legs. Now we are ready for step number 4. Step number 4 is basically the transition, the full transition into the underwater realm. And to do this, notice how Yasemin is not gonna keep her lead leg just stiff, straight up in the air, waiting to see what happens. She actually continues the motion that she started with the lead leg, and she moves it all the way to the other end as if she was kicking. Notice how the knee on her lead leg is gonna bend, and it's gonna continue to bend. By bending the knee on the lead leg, by doing this restricted kick, as we call it, she has able to get that blade fully submerged while continuing the downward push. Now, what we have is that the follow leg is able to perform a full kick while barely touching the surface of the water. Right here, you can see that both fin tips are fully submerged, and we can now transition to step number 5, which is to initiate the full width descent kicks. And notice here that by the time she has completed about 3 full kick cycles, she is already about 25 feet deep, 8 or so meters deep underwater, in complete control, having not once splashed any water on the surface, wasted any of her energy by kicking up in the air. And all of this has been done in a very relaxed, smooth, fluid manner. Let's watch it again. Step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, step 5. She is 20 feet deep already. Perfect. Now, let's talk about the most common problems that I've seen divers experience, not only with our technique, but in general during entry. The first thing is, of course, that they cannot obtain enough negative buoyancy to sink below the surface. We always advocate that divers should be under ballasted, that you should only use enough weight on your weight belt to allow you to reach a certain depth with a logical amount of effort. Generally, we should be ballasted enough that while breathing normally on the surface, again, tested in this vertical position, not floating on your belly or on your back, but vertical in the water, the water level is somewhere around your neck. If this is the case, then you are properly ballasted. If you still have issues coming down, then after that, the number one cause for all problems is always the same, and it's always very simple, that the divers do not have forward momentum. You guessed it. Now, remember something. When we have forward momentum and we start bending our upper body to go underwater, what we do is that we are using that forward momentum by changing direction to help push us down. And what I've seen is many divers that either kick feebly, weakly enough that they don't really move forward at all, or they do it and they kick a lot, but then they pause.
The dreaded pause of inefficiency.
Then what comes next is also very common. Then you're gonna lift the other leg and try to use both legs to push it down to no avail. And then what's gonna happen next, of course, is that divers are gonna start frantically kicking air on the surface, hoping that this will push them down. It is water that you need to be displacing, not air. But at that point, you are already exhausted, you have burned through a large part of your oxygen reserve, and you're not gonna start your dive in the right frame of mind. All of this sequence of horrible and inconvenient events resulting from the simple fact that you either did not attain forward momentum or that you did not keep it. Second problem that I have seen, all right? I have seen guys, like we will see in this video right now, that kind of go out of alignment. Instead of starting to go down vertically, they start going down backwards at a 45-degree angle. This simply happens because as the lead leg passes the vertical alignment, this motion happens way too fast. So what to do to remedy this? It's very simple. Make that transition with your lead leg slow. Now, can this be tweaked to be used with a monofin? Yes, it can be. And yes, we are gonna have a different video to show how it works with a monofin, because obviously with the monofin, there is no lead leg and there is no follow leg. Both legs are gonna come up at the same time. But the essence of the procedure is the same. You will attain forward momentum. You will start attaining vertical alignment for your upper body, and then both of your legs are gonna come down. The only thing that will change is that the transition kick is going to happen with both legs, and the chambering of the knees is going to be a little bit more pronounced than if it was with two fins. That will be the only adjustment. And then from there on, after that first kick, down you go, and you will continue as before. This entry uses, it's based on very simple mechanical principles that will always work. I'm gonna run this video one more time. Look at this. From surface to 20 feet, 6 meters deep, in about 6 to 7 seconds. People, it doesn't get any better than that. And this can be done by anybody, so long, of course, as you practice enough. So, that was the first skill in our series of ultra-efficient techniques, and join us next. Hang on one second. Did I tell you guys how important it is to attain forward momentum? I didn't? Well then, the most important thing, I did. More than once, several times. All right then, attain forward momentum. Everything else follows after that.